Hello, and happy holidays to you all. So this year, I decided to make some DIYs for my holiday stockings. So in the stockings, I have the hot pot pad, which could also be used as a pot coaster. I have the cosmetic bags, which could also be used to store pencils and small little items. And I also made some scarves too. But in this tutorial, I'll be focusing on the hot pot pad. So, let's get started. First, we need to make a template for the shapes of the coasters or the pads. So get a ruler, a pencil, and a paper. Draw out a square measuring 8 inches all around. When you're done with the lines, measure on each of the lines, starting from the corners of each angles of the square, 1 inch each on each line. So when you're done with this lines or marking out these inches on each of these lines, connect those dots with a curved ruler. Or you could also use your hand to freehand join the lines to make a curve. When you're done with this curve, use a scissors to cut it out. Here is what the paper template looks like after cutting. So use the template to cut out 2 insole fleece. I'm just using an old fleece that I have. 2 fabrics. Then bring out a template again. Fold it into 1/3 of the paper to make another kind of template. Make sure it's all even and straight. Use this template to cut out 2 fabrics. This could be the same fabric like as you used earlier or a new contrast one, and also a fleece. Turn this fabric right side facing down, put the fleece in the middle, then turn the other fabric on top of the fleece, just like you have in right here. Then go ahead and sew using 1/2 inch all around. When you're done, cut it all the way down to almost a 1/4 inch. So this will help when you're adding the bias tape. When you're done, bring out the other fabric. Lay it down with the right side facing down. Put the first fleece on top and the second fleece on top of it. Then also put the other fabric on top with the right side facing up. Lay them together and make it a line. Then go to the machine and sew them all around with 1/2 inches or 1/2 inch. When you're done, trim it down into 1/4 inch, just like we did with the other layer of fabric earlier in the tutorial. Make sure you're watching your line so it doesn't go all the way into the stitches that you make. When done cutting, bring out the contrast fabric with a shorter layer. Bring out the bias tape and iron it flat. Pin it together with the fabric and take it to the machine and sew. When you're done sewing, you have to fold it a quarter of an inch. Remember, you sewed it with a quarter of an inch too. Then turn it once again into half an inch, just like you have right here. Then pin it together. Just to make it stay so it won't shift while you're sewing. Take it to the machine and sew it straight line all the way. And here is what it looks like after I finished sewing it. So place it right on top of the bigger fabric, or the bigger layer, I would say. Pin it together so it doesn't shift while you're adding the bias tape. Once again, take a bias tape and open it flat. Turn the coaster upside down, or the pad upside down, to the other side that doesn't have the shorter layer on top of it. Then start pinning your bias tape all the way onto the pad or coaster. Make sure you pin it all the way around. And be careful with the needles too. So once you get to the end of the pin, leave 2 or 3 inches out. Take them to the machine and start sewing around. And make sure while you're sewing it that you're being careful, because it could easily shift. So that's why we have the pin holding it together. So here's what it looks like after I got done sewing it. So I'm going to turn it inside the bias tape. Then I'm going to do the same thing like I did earlier. I will fold it quarter of an inch. I remember when I was sewing it, I sewed it with quarter of an inch too. So I'm going to turn it quarter of an inch first, then flip it over half an inch again. And pin it around while you're doing this, so it will help to put things in shape and not shift while you're sewing. Take it to the machine and sew. But before you sew at the machine, make sure the little extra fabric that is on the bias tape that you fold it to, you fold it quarter of an inch from one side, quarter of an inch from the other side, then fold the two of them together. I couldn't get a closer look of this because my daughter wasn't around to help me zoom off the video. I could have easily showed you better. So I'm just making sure that everything is aligned together and straight before taking it to the machine. And once you have the machine, make sure that the needles are placed properly on those tape, because it could easily shift. So be careful while sewing it. So here is what it looks like after sewing the bias tape all around, and also that's the extra bias that was left. So you just flip this over to the back and use a pin to hold it and sew it in. This will be the holder of the hot pot pad, so you can use it to hang it somewhere near the stove or whatever you want to hang it. So flip it around and use a pin to hold it down. Then take it to the machine and sew it down. So that's the end of the pad. Let me know what you think. And in case you have anything you want me to sew, leave a comment down below too. So here are different varieties that I made. Thanks for watching, and I will catch you in the next video. Bye.